Good day, students. Welcome to today's class. Our topic is linear transformation. And this linear transformation has been lingering for long. We've discussed rotation, we've discussed reflection, and today we are looking at enlargement and reduction. In the course of this study, these are the two terms that you need to put into consideration so that you can understand what is actually reduction and what is actually what? Enlargement. I said you will be seeing terms like object and what? Image. Like object is simply the substance you are putting into consideration. Object is simply the substance you are putting into consideration. Then that object you are putting into consideration, what the same thing it produced, like that looks like him, is known as what? Image. The only thing we need to know is that the image might be bigger than the object, and in some cases the image might be what? Smaller than the what? Object. So our specific objective for today is that at the end of this lesson, you should be able to A. identify image that has undergone enlargement. Then B. you should also be able to identify image that has undergone reduction, and problems involving reduction and enlargement, you should be able to solve them. Now, the areas we are looking at enlargement and reduction simultaneously. We don't want to consider them independently. Why? Because in the process of discussing enlargement, common sense will help you to also know how to go about what? Reduction. The difference between enlargement and reduction is just that enlargement, the image is greater than the object. But reduction, the object is greater than the word image. But in both circumstances, we must be clear to know that you don't expect to have a substance and it should produce another different substance as image. No, it will produce its like, but it is either its like will be greater than it or its like will be what? Less than it. So, in that case, where the image is bigger than the object, we call that process what? Enlargement. But in the process where the image is smaller compared to the object, we call that process what? Reduction. But there must be a rational relationship between the corresponding sides of the shapes, because automatically the two shapes must become what? Similar shapes. In other words, the relationship between the corresponding sides must be the same throughout. So looking at this shape, it will enable you to understand what enlargement and reduction means. So if you look at the rectangle with the label object, you see it is a little bit bigger. Then if you look at the rectangle labeled image of enlargement, you find out that this image is bigger than the word object. This is what we call what? Enlargement. Then if you look at the other one, it is labeled what? Image of reduction. So if you look at the image of reduction, it is slightly less than the object. That means that it is the image of what? Reduction. I hope with these three examples, you should have a creative picture of what? Enlargement and what? Reduction. So the diagram we just consider above, if you observe carefully, you will see that the image of enlargement is greater than the object, which I've already told you, and the image of reduction is smaller than the object. But in order to explain this better, using matrices, we have to use a single graph to a a unit square object to explain this, with the vertices of the unit square to be what? O, which is the origin, it has a coordinate of 0, 0. And A, which with the coordinate 1, 0. That means that it is a point on the what? X-axis. And C has a coordinate of what? 0, 1, which means that it is a point on the what? Y-axis. So if you trace C horizontally and A diagonally, you find out that the two of them intersect at a point which has a coordinate of what? 1, 1. We should consider that 1, 1 to be what? Point B. When enlarged or reduced, the coordinate of the object produced by OABC will be different from the coordinates of the object as shown below. Please, I want us to understand that with reduction and enlargement, we always have a role to play for us to understand that enlargement, the object, the image will be bigger than the object, but reduction, the image will be what? Less than the what? Will be smaller compared to the what? Object. So looking at this graph above here, you find out that what? Shape OABC, it is the original shape, while in enlargement, when it is enlarged to K on the X on the Y axis and K on the what? X axis, you find out that the both of them intersect at the point what? KK, which in the object, the point of B is what? 1, 1. So with this, you find out that what? O, C prime, B prime, and what? A prime, they are the image. And OCAB, it is the object put into consideration. Looking at the smaller one is also explaining what? Reduction simultaneously. Looking at the smaller one is also explaining what? Reduction simultaneously. So from this graph above, we want to derive our what? Image matrix produced by what? Enlargement. So now we look at the point that we consider in what? Transformation, because we know that what? Point OABC, they are the 4 points are not too relevant in determining the what? Transformation matrix, because O and B always give similar or the same coordinate, but A and C always tend to give us a different coordinate. So therefore, we change the coordinate of what? A and C into column matrix. The coordinate of A is what? 1, 0, and the coordinate of C is what? 0, 1. So when you transform 1, 0, it will give you what? K, 0. And when you transform what? 0, 1, it will give you what? 0, K. So combining the two transformation matrices obtained, you will now have what? K0 and 0K as our what? Transformation matrix under what? Enlargement and reduction. So now I want us to look at this example. Don't expect all exercises to look like this. It might come in different form. Anyhow, you should be able to trace it and get your answer. If you look at my transformation matrix, I always use M as my transformation matrix. But questions might come where the examiner might not use M as their word transformation matrix. But you should be technical enough to dictate which one is what? The transformation matrix. So let's look at this example. Example 1 says that what? Find the effect of the matrix R is equal to what? 3, 0, 0, 3. So this is the matrix that they want us to know the effect on man. So they said the square whose vertices are, that is the square where we are going to carry out this exercise. You see that what? The vertices are what? O, which is 0, 0, and A, which is 1, 0, and B, which is what? 1, 1, and C, which is what? 0, 1. This problem, we can solve it individually, and we can solve them together. But to me, I don't want us to solve it what? Individually. I want us to solve it what? Together, so that we can get it what? Better. So you see that immediately I dictate the question, I find out that they gave me a particular matrix to see the effect on another object. So we also use this information to know that what? It is either enlargement or what? Reduction. So in the case where I want my work to be very, very fast, I might bring the coordinates of all the potential fathers and put them into what? Into 2x4 matrix. So you see our formula which says that what? Q is equal to what? MP is not wrong. So we know that M is what? 3003. Then P, now the P is using what? Matrix 2x4. Why is it using 2x4? That simply means that we have the coordinate of 4 different vertices. That is why we have what? 2x4 matrix. So if you are carrying out matrix like this, that simply means that the row of what? The first matrix should be equal to the what? Column of the second matrix. So look at this step here. I use 3 to multiply 0 and I use 0 to multiply 0. The both of them give us what? 0. Then the next step, I use what? 3 to multiply 1 and I use 0 to multiply 0. And I have 3 plus what? 0. Then the next step, I use 5 to multiply 1 and I use what? I use 3 to multiply 1 and I use 0 to multiply 1. We also have what? 0. Then we use 3 to multiply 0 and 0 to multiply 1. It also gives us what? 0. So you find out that what? The second step of finding Q is now corresponding to the what? Question. So let's look at the next step. It is the product of the multiplication. So what do we have here? We have what? 0, 3, 3, 0, 0, 0, 3. So from this very matrix here, you can pick out the coordinate of the object produced based on the positioning which you have done in the what? Based on the position in which you have done in the what? Object matrix. So the first two things we are considering is 0, 0, which are the point of what? O. And A prime is considered to be what? 3, 0, which is the what? Second coordinate. Then B is what? 3, 3. B is what? 3, 3. E has already finished his job. Then this means that what? C prime also will be what? 0, 3. By this factor, we know that what? The enlargement scale factor is what? 3. So I believe that this exercise has opened your eye to the what? Assignment. What is the assignment? The assignment here, just copy the question, solve it and submit to my Google Classroom properly, please. Submit it properly. And if you know you are in my Google class and you're using a separate name, please change it before you get to my class. Oh, thank you for watching and have a nice day. Please stay safe. God bless you. Bye.